was one of the most surreal moments of my life. To the left, a woman and her mom were both completely drunk. To my right, my dad was standing up, eyes closed, head down, rocking out on air guitar. To his right, a couple had listened to one song and got up and left. And lo and behold, on stage, gray-haired Wilde was the Archbishop of Anarchy, the High Priest of Protest, the Duke of Disobedience, and simply Bob Dylan. In the beginning of the semester, I said I could talk all class about him. That's not really true. I could actually teach a whole semester on him, maybe two. So it's going to be a challenge to fit all that into a couple of minutes. So I figured I'd start off from the beginning. When I was 13 years old at my first bar mitzvah, I was dancing with my parents to Forever Young. Back then, I couldn't even tell you the name of the song, let alone who wrote it. It wasn't until high school that I really started listening to the music in my dad's car. And I listened to a couple songs, but I listened to them over and over again. And once my brother left for college, he took with him the classical music from the house and his cello, and it was replaced with a blaring harmonica and me singing at the top of my lungs awfully. From there, I went from a couple songs to albums and albums, and I listened to them constantly. I looked online, I looked behind the references he made, I looked at the backgrounds of the song, I looked at what other people thought the songs meant, and I formed my own opinion of what I disagreed with or agreed with. I read countless books, I read biographies, autobiographies. My dad even gave me an old coffee-stained book, Tarantula, Dylan's first ever book he wrote. I watched countless videos for concerts on YouTube. I watched movies he was in, movies about him, and finally I was able to see him in concert. Bruce Springsteen once said that Bob Dylan freed your mind the way Elvis freed your body. And it's thanks to Dylan I have been released.